Thank you. Thank you. It's a real pleasure to be here, and it's like I really feel among a group of friends, because not only do I know some of you personally, but most of my research over the past 20 years has been about the issues that we discuss, and Donella Meadows has always been one of, I suppose, one of those people able to inspire my work and the work of many other people across generations, and I still find her work, speaking about women that made a difference, her work extremely inspiring, not only from a biological as well as physical point of view, but also as a political visionary. And I think, you know, what I want to say is that basically, I think the time for research is over, in a sense. Like, we have done the research, now it's time for the action, for politics and for governance. And in a sense, you know, like, my entire life has been about this. I mean, I left my city. I'm from Rome. When I was 19, and I lived in the United States, in the UK, in Germany, and the past 17 years in South Africa, by the way. Sawubona mama, you know. Amanta. So for those of you who understand what we talked about, it's just like, you know, power to the people. It is time we go back to the basics, and we understand that. And I think, in a sense, you know, like, even just the fact that I'm speaking English and not Italian, I'm re-educating myself in my home language. This is still my home. My home is planet Earth. I have no intention to go to another planet. Even if we found one, it was habitable. So, that's why I was with some of you in Pretoria, where I was living until 5 months ago, during a conference that we had about the idea of well-being entering the economic conversation, rather than growth. And we're just having a conversation in November, and I said to them, look, I may become a minister in a few months. I think I'm going to accept the offer. And I did it, and I did it for this reason. The only reason why I entered the political terrain, which, as Virginia knows, is really, really not comfortable, I'm telling you. It's not, for normal people, getting into politics is not an easy, it's not a walk in the park. But it's because I thought, I want to bring these issues away from universities and textbooks. I want to bring them into the political conversations of every day. And I'm proud to say that the party that I belong to has created an entire platform based on the concept of the quality of life. During the electoral campaign, we never spoke about economic growth. We simply said, what we promise to do is to improve the quality of life of Italian citizens and people living in this country. Then, of course, the day-to-day of politics changes you, and this is really important. You may come here with as many values and principles as you want, but until you change the governance structures within which you're operating, the business as usual will prevail. Because it's easy to say, thank you, it's easy to say, as I did, we need more focus on the quality of life. We need to talk about a post-growth economy. The economic growth model that we have, we all know that, it's not compatible with life on this planet. It isn't. You can try and fix it here and there and tweak around the edges, but it is not compatible. We need to change that model. But when you then talk to Brussels and the European Union and the entire global economy, they tell you either the investors pull money away from your country, or because they're scared of what they don't know, or the governance principles within which you're operating tell you that is not possible. So this is, I think, the new challenge. The challenge is that these ideas have to become political and have to somehow to contaminate regional governments, national governments, global governments. I think I'm appealing to the younger members of the Club of Rome. Sorry, this is not a judgment. I'm just saying the younger ones that still have a few years to change their career path.
What's your gap of youth?
I'm 40, so I put myself in the bracket. So
do
let's
I
say,
get to be
in
there
any
too?
Case, this is not a personal judge. This is not a judgment, but I think consider doing something. Consider using your knowledge, your expertise to get something done. That may very well be about joining the Rethinking Economics movement, which I think is extremely important in universities. That's what I've done years ago, teaching students a different development path, a different development theory, that what they read every day and get examined on is not the only narrative, it's not the only possibility. Important. As the Deputy Minister of Education, that is my job now. I have the power to say in schools, we're going to have to teach our pupils that competition is not necessarily the best way to achieve your goals, that the ideal career may not be the conventional ones, but maybe more about common good, about being caretakers. The whole idea of caretakers, I love it. I love the idea of care as a principle that is so basic. We should teach our kids to care about each other and to care about Mother Nature because they're part of it, as simple as that. And the same applies to universities and research enterprises, research institutes. We need to change the way in which we have conceptualized research. We need to change the paradigms. We have to change the performance assessments. We cannot tell people that if they do interdisciplinary research, they're not good enough, when interdisciplinary research is the key to a better world. You need to make sure to get out of the silos. You cannot be just an economist. You have to be an economist with an understanding of a biology, Bob, I'm talking about you to a certain extent. You know, like an economist with an understanding of biology, of ecology, of planetary boundaries. I don't know if Jon Rockström is already here. And if you're an engineer, you have to understand that bridges and buildings are inhabited by people and they have to interact with nature. You don't live in a bubble. And the same applies to other disciplines. And that has become my task. Even when I was in South Africa, I worked with the National Research Foundation to make sure we broke the silos. So finally, and I want to conclude with this, my appeal is to, after 50 years from the 1972 Limits to Growth report, which sold 3 million copies, and it was ridiculed by a lot of people that are still in a position of power, you know, as much as we can, you know, for everything that Bill Nordhaus has done, which is good, he was one of those ridiculing the Limits to Growth report, and I think, you know, it's fine that he has changed his mind, but it wouldn't be bad if he said one word about some of the mistakes he made in the past and that economists keep making. So, sorry, I'm telling the truth. You guys know that. So, because in this way, I think we need to regain the credibility of the alternative, of an alternative vision, which is the only one. It's not that we're, you know, people tell me, but you know, yeah, growth is incompatible, maybe to a certain extent the current model of growth is not compatible with planetary boundaries. I say more, it's not even compatible with happiness and well-being. It's not, we're destroying the planet, as a friend of mine told me once, we're destroying the planet and we're not even having so much fun at it, so I think there's something wrong. So to get, you know, to find the courage to become political with a couple of colleagues, I wrote a letter to in the Guardian, published in the Guardian at the beginning of September, and this letter has been translated into 27 languages. All member states of the European Union have translated the letter, and the letter says one thing. We ask the European Union, we're members of the European Union can make a difference, especially the new European Union after the May elections. We ask them to start thinking about a post-growth model for this continent and show the rest of the world that it is possible and it is desirable, not only possible, but it is desirable. And the Club of Rome is as, you know, like timing and relevant today as it was in 1972. Thank you.